Yeah, Joyeux Noël, in case this is posting on the 24th, which is the day where we celebrate Christmas here in Austria. I'll say this now, I've made a bunch of videos and you'll hear this a whole lot, so there you go. It's a video that I wanted to get in the games in the Netherlands. The last two before Christmas just finished, and I said, okay, let's get the video of. I've only seen a teeny bit of the PSG game against Lorient, and the rest is mostly results. So let's see where this will take us in this video. However, I gotta say, I mean, for me, the overarching theme is PSG is so rotten at the moment. They seem so beatable, even with a Messi playing well. They seem so beatable. No one does it. They always strike back at the last minute. But what's even more is that all the contenders are beating themselves in showing who is the most inept in catching PSG. I mean, at this point, I think PSG probably doesn't need to win another game this season anymore, it looks like, because the others are taking points and dropping points left and right. I don't see any team in any way challenging PSG, and PSG is rotten. And this is such it's a statement that I really hate to say, because I really like Liga, but this ineptitude of especially the Lyons and the Marseilles, and yeah, to a certain degree now, Rennes, Monaco, all those teams that you thought they could challenge, they're just not. So the games were all played on Wednesday evening at 9 o'clock. So that was interesting. I actually like it. There were a few remarkable results. I mean, especially a few turnarounds. To say the first one of those occurred in Bordeaux, where Lille found themselves down twice, and in the second half they come back with Jonathan David actually finishing the job. Pretty big win for Lille, and I'm not saying anyway that Lille will challenge PSG, but I think Lille probably has a shot to maybe look into European spots kind of soon. The Clermont Strasbourg game had to be postponed due to adverse weather. I mean, to not have a COVID postponement seems like good news at the moment. There was seemingly fog and a little bit of winter and so on. So that did not get played. So we are not officially at the halfway point of the season yet. Lorient PSG. Many chances missed. As I said, Messi played well. He hit, I think, for the sixth time in Liga already the post. I don't know how many goals does he have, one or two? So he really likes French goalposts, seemingly. And then Monconduit with a great shot gives Lorient the lead. And Lorient, I think they've lost quite a few in a row, and they were almost about to beat PSG. PSG having the same problems, not very well organized, not playing well together. Yeah, Mbappé and Neymar missing, that can always hurt you. But the one thing that I have to give to PSG is that they are always there to score and save themselves in the last minute. And that even despite Sergio Ramos opening his account with red cards in France now as well, getting two yellow cards within 5 minutes. Late on, that's pretty Sergio Ramos in a way. The equalizer came through Icardi, who again, I mean, not showing anything in a game show, but he's there, he converts. It's 1-1. It's not a great result. I mean, PSG is figuring here on my wall rather low in the changes, but since no one else is wanna get wins and kind of close the gap, PSG still very much up there, and like, at least if not statistically, they are the moral winners of this match day. So speaking of the inept teams, Lyon, whatever they do, 5 games they have won. They get the lead in the 56th through Lukeba, and then Traoré 2 minutes later equalizes for Metz. Marseille, even worse, found themselves down against Stade Reims for I think it was kind of late-ish, yeah, a Ekitike, In the 75th scores the go-ahead goal for Reus. And then it needs a 97th minute penalty to get an equalizer. As I said, there were a bunch of comebacks. The first one is Rennes was up through Terrier, but Ben Yedda with a penalty of Folland gave Monaco all the win. And the same thing, Lens also were up at Nice. And then Justin Kluivert, yes, this guy, scored the winner. And Nice is one of the few winners in this round. So it's, as I said, pretty remarkable. Now we have a longish break. We have 2 weeks off. It comes back, Eric, actually with quite the classic matchup between Bordeaux and Marseille. And then Lyon against PSG, kind of a big one. Last chance for Lyon to, or is anyone to close the gap. Another traditional duel between Nantes and Monaco. But Lens against Stade Rennes is also there. But yeah, I'm still a little bit in shock of how inept the Ligue 1 teams is. It's a 13-point lead. As I said. Briefly on the Netherlands, where it's the first round of the of the spring season, just played before Christmas. They're gonna squeeze it in maybe because there's a Dutch Cup coming up. All the big boys won. Feyenoord get a 3-0 away win at Heerenveen. One higher than Ajax there. Ajax 5-0 over Sittard, also everything that you would expect. And this afternoon or early evening, PSV with Mvene, Austrian, scoring 2-0 over Go Ahead Eagles, meaning that in the Netherlands nothing really changed. It's still PSV up top. It's a little bit surprising. They come back. They have a 3-week break, so a little bit longer with Feyenoord, with Hess probably the outstanding game there. Utrecht Ajax probably is more interesting for the fans. However, after that round, this is kind of the warm-up round, because then we get the big one, PSV Ajax. And I would say almost a must-win for PSV. But we gotta see. So yeah, that was it from me for this year from France and the Netherlands. Please, if you have seen more than me, there's a good chance you have. If you're interested in this video, please drop a line below. Give me a thumbs up if you enjoyed this video. Subscribe to my channel if you want to see more. And we'll talk to you soon. Bye. Hey there, I really hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, here are some videos and playlists that you actually might enjoy too. Also, please consider subscribing to my channel and click that little bell, so in order to stay updated whenever something happens in my soccer universe. With that, have a good day.